I was working a comedy club. The owner of the club brought us to a restaurant. And I noticed that the lighting was really good. It was just a really very relaxed atmosphere. And I talked to the owner about it, him and his wife. And she goes, yeah, sometimes people go, it's hard to read the menu. We can't read the menu. It's so dark in here. And he goes, good, good. You can read the menu easily. That means something's not right here. That means the atmosphere isn't right. He goes, it's okay if people are pulling out their cell phones and trying to look at the menu. That's okay. That's good. That's all right. And that's how I feel at my parties. Like, sometimes it's a little dark, but that, it's good. That's what's comfortable. I might be a little over the top, but most of my ideas, everybody should follow. With all the prep I do get to the point at the party where I can enjoy myself. Because it's so much fucking prep. But by the time the party gets here, creating an atmosphere that they don't see all the time, it just feels like, oh, it's like, I mean, it feels like you're on vacation. Because, yeah, obviously when you go somewhere, that's what they do. They create a different atmosphere so you can do it at your own home. So when you're in the house and it's dark at night, one torch. This torch was, what, $10? These cans are $3. One outside the window. So if you're in the house and you're looking outside at night and you're in my home and you're sitting on the sofa, you look outside, you see a lit torch. You just don't see it all the time. So it makes you feel like you're somewhere different. Most people, you go over the house, it's like on a scale from 1 to 10, let's say 10's the brightest, it's a 10. I'm like, are you shitting me? There you go, come on in. Relax, let's smoke a little pot. I hope I created a nice mood. Oh, what mood is that? Oh, I turned all my lights on as bright as they could be. So fucking have fun, and I hope it's tranquil and fun for everybody. When I go around the house, when it's dark, you can only do it when it's dark, and you get them to a right place, then I take the scotch tape, they can't go right or left. I do it in the bathrooms too, because the truth is, no one likes the way they look. If you go into the bathroom and it's nice and dark, you go in there, you look better, yeah, you're in a better mood. If I was in a movie theater trying to get into the atmosphere and a side door opened not every 20 seconds, maybe every 20 minutes, the side door opened and shut. You know, I'd be like, dude, I'm trying to watch a movie, and that's how I feel people are at a party. They're in an atmosphere. You know, they're drinking or they're smoking or they're just, you know, they don't have to do either. But and then every 2 minutes, and so I unscrew the bulb because when it's dark in here, that's very obvious. So my thing is that everything prepared. I got coffee here, hot water. They can turn it on. I don't want to brew coffee because most of the time they don't drink it. I got these Starbucks. People aren't coming to my house for great coffee. So I have these. People go, yeah, it's right there. They can walk over, do it. Just, it's done. I don't have to think. There's the sugar. There's all types. There's that. There's this. Milk's in the refrigerator. Probably I'll even put a little milk out too. So I don't even have to, they don't ask me that. Like I said, I'm not a big cook, but I like to doctor stuff. And I just, you know, I'll just think like, I know people like ice cream cake, but I thought, you know, ice cream cake is, I like it, but it's never great. It's like the cake is, but yet I'm still obsessed with ice cream cake. I'm always like, oh, ice cream cake. So I tried this once and it worked really good. I take it, I cut it like that. Then I just take this, it's not brain surgery. Then that, you take that, put it there. It's so good. Because you know what it is? You have the warm Pop-Tart, and then the sweetness, but not only do you have the sweetness, you have the it's like the glaze from the Pop-Tart, and then the cold ice cream and the warm Pop-Tart. They're pretty good. About a year ago, I was cleaning this garage out, and I thought, you know what, I could just make like an outdoor garage. It's sort of old wood and everything, and this table I had, I built this. When I say built it, actually, a carpenter built it, but I got all the planks, I got the legs, he assembled it. That's what I call building it. And then I just, you know, I just have big dinners out here. I don't think we're gonna be out here tonight. Maybe we will. We might come out here tonight.
Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah, for dinner, you have to wear a blue blazer, and then you just sort of take one down. I think I might have one in your size. You know, like one of those restaurants where they have a bunch of blazers sometimes they'll give you.
My friend Lynn, who is gonna be here tonight with his wife, he'll do a lot of this stuff for me because he's very talented, and he can play the trumpet, he can play the piano, he can play the violin, he can play the guitar. There'll be other music playing, I'll be like, let's get this fucking party started! One time when
when we had dinner in that outside room that I showed you, there was 30 people probably in a big, big circle. And out of nowhere, I said, wouldn't it be great if we could have a song? And Lynn had the amp already hooked up in the corner. Again, I had that spotlight, the same one. And all of a sudden, Lynn just strums the guitar and sings So It Is Christmas. Now, when he first strummed it, everyone's like laughing because it's like so out of the blue. But then he was singing it. He's got a great voice. And there was a moment where everyone's sitting around. It's dark, just the candles, the glow of the candles, a red spotlight on him, singing, echoing through the room. And people stopped and went, oh, this is really special. Like, this is really cool. And you know what's fun? There's somebody coming late. My friend Blake Wexler is coming late because he's at a baseball game. And like, so we can, since we're all here early, we can plan a bit to just do for him. Just something like so overwhelming. Like you know what I thought of? Here's what was in my head. Like, he'll knock on the door. We'll have the music pretty low. Just mellow music in the background. And I'll go, hey Blake, what's happening? And then maybe I'll turn everyone. I go, come on, Blake's here. Let's pick this fucking party up a notch. And then Lynn will be on the drums. Boom, boom. Chris, see, and in this case, Chris is on the music. Just something like Disco Inferno. Boom. The drums. Boom. And then this, everyone just starts dancing around. Like with, but it happens like that, right? And then you're gonna, bring them in, and people are gonna make their own sandwiches in there. Hey, by the way, tell some people they look fat. That way they'll eat less. It's an old trick. You do that. You go, oh, you gain weight? No, it's all right. Hey, how many bagels you want? Just one? Okay. Hey, how you doing? Lisa, you're pregnant. I thought you couldn't get. You're. Oh my God. Hey, how much ice cream cake do you want? That way, there's more for you. That's funny.
I mean, one day if I looked over, Rob, are you shitting me?
What?
You fucking put the butter on. These are going to be high people. Here's you. Rob, down here.
You say, okay? I'll get a little, there. Get a little butter on that, there. Fucking, you do it real. Like, there.
That much fucking butter?
Yes. Yeah. It's going to burn off most of it. That's what my doctor told me. I'll do it.
Why can't I just relax and do this?
It's true. It's like I don't relax. Like right now, I'm not enjoying this, but it's better than watching him do it wrong.
Oh. How are you doing?
Thank
you
for having me.
You're welcome. You know, you're. It's right. You don't want people starve, but you don't want them stuffed. It's all right if they're hungry. So I was like, oh, because I would do the put out 10 times as much. But then I realized people get stuffed.
And then they leave.
Not that there's dinner, but yeah, normally you're right. They don't eat dinner. Yeah. So the trick is to keep people hungry because people want food. That's what I'm going to be doing with everyone here tonight. Remember, be over complimentary. Everyone is insecure. Be nice, attentive, listen.
Todd, you're very funny and successful.
Oh, Rory, you look good. Rory, you look good. It's not me. I'm doing good.
That's why everyone turns it on you. Yeah.
No, I mean for these other fucking idiots.
Every time, if we're ever shooting anything, I always say that, like, I can see someone thinking, well, they're just doing that. You know, like the music stuff, but it's stuff I always do. But even when they're shooting it, I'm aware. I'm like, would I do this?
And the answer is,
yeah, you're right. Then I check myself. That's my only point. But other than that, I hope you enjoy the little soft shoot.
That's how nervous I get. I just do old stuff. When my baby, my old baby, when are you going to love me now? Hello, my darling. Hello, my heart. I think this is helping, but it's ruining it. But I think any empty noise. I'm going to love you a long time. And she comes. Oh, look out there. Oh, my God. It's your grandmother. I'm a Yankee Doodle Dad. It's a review show. Hey. I'm having so much fun.
I don't know why, I might be higher than everybody.
That was so much fun to do.
Yes.
Guys!
I just let you tell us something a little cooler.
Guys! Oh my God, I can't believe it in there.
Say, spread the word, he's got cancer.
I've got cancer. I didn't know how to tell you guys, I didn't want to be dramatic about it. I don't know what I'm gonna do, but
guys mean the world to me. I mean, these last few months have been very difficult, and to have friends like you and you and... I'll pay the mortgage. I'm not worried about that. I don't know where it's going to come. You know, you're all rich friends of mine. But you know, big, I'll get that. You're like, well, and then the next day you guys call each other, like, you're like Steven Spielberg. You have to go, yeah, you got it. That's just, you got to pay us. Yeah, we look like assholes if we don't help you. But meanwhile, I know it's on me like this. You know what? Sometimes I don't even care if I lose this whole place. And that's all I wanted. Okay, thanks. Shut the fuck up. Just wanted 20 bucks. He's that much of a motherfucker. He figures if he starts high like that, someone will give him 20 bucks to shut him up. And that's all I really wanted. He's because he wants to eat gas on the way home.
Yes.
Anyway,
hey,
put the music back on, please. What if we were, that was our real relationship? So much tension until we both broke and went, I guess that's why I love you. How you doing, honey? Do it again, you ready?
Yeah.
What are you doing at my house? I can't stand when I see you.
You told me to come!
How about fuck yourself?
How about
you know
fuck
what?
Yourself?
You know why you had four divorces? Nobody would fuck you. Nobody would fuck you. Four guys would fuck you.
Nobody would fuck me. I fucked everyone.
How you
nobody
doing,
would
huh?
fucking touch
you.
You
look great. Come here.
How
you doing?
Hi.
How you
thank
look
you
great.
For having me.
Yeah, it's good to see you.
Thank you very much.
And what else? This will be an hour from now. Those are Pop-Tarts with vanilla ice cream. Okay?
That's a sweet glaze on the outside. Ice cream's inside, another Pop-Tart on the bottom. You're gonna shit in your fucking pants all 55 minutes from now. If I think you're all in the so, don't just sit around like loads of shit. Let's dance and the music comes on. Otherwise, I will throw those down the trash.
Is he not just the most feline? Like, he's so
great. You're right.
Hey, guys.
Holy fuck.
What?
The pig thing?
Which one is it? I'm serious. I'm not lying. I only have 50 years to live. Is it funny, Samantha? You fucking piece of shit. Everything's a joke there. What if this was my nice speech? Like, I was going to come up and be nice, but then I end up... Anyway, it's good to have you fucking knuckleheads here. See, your Aunt Vivian still drinks up. But we're not comics. This really happened somewhere. Anyway, obviously you can tell I've been having a good year in my new outdoor dining room. I want you to be jealous. I know, it's a lot more flashier than it looks. But I do appreciate if my friends would wear blue blazers when they come over here. Give a little respect to the garage. I hate to be a dick about it, but if you could kindly draw on a blue blazer. It did say blue blazer on the invitation. Yes, it did. Anyway, if you could do that, be very respectful to the owner of this place.
I said no one together.
I said no engage people. That's our thing.
Everybody together. We're, don't be a fucking prick.
Yeah. I don't want to get engaged.
There's no difference.
I have an idea.
It doesn't matter now.
I guess it doesn't matter.
Since we're editing, I think it'll be funny after that big yell and all that tension between Rory. I turn to you and I go, please do it. You just start singing all the way through while just sitting there like this. Thank you. Without missing a beat. Yeah, I think that'll be really funny.
Is that what you like?
Is that okay? Rory, come back.
We would do this if the cameras weren't on.
Rory,
that's what I mean. It has nothing to do. We would do the exact same thing. Would we not, or am I crazy?
You're high.
We would. No, we would.
No, no,
we
no.
Would. We would.
Thank
we
you.
Would.
Come. Oh, God, thank you. Just when you need someone to take you off under the bus.
Okay, I'd like Rory.
Okay, Rory, where are you?
I'd like Rory and Jordan to come up here because I want to sing them a special song for their end of
their engagement. Well, no, we're past that.
So you're going to pass on. So do this song.
And then do this.
And then, you know what? I should invite Eric and Sam up, too. Because they're engaged, too. And we can do this together.
Yeah, it's perfect.
Do us first.
Rory, it's a family thing. It's just happiness together. We're sharing.
I said no other engaged couples. I want just that's our thing.
Rory, you're ruining a dinner. Come on.
No. I said
Rory,
no other couples.
It's two fucking people that are having a joyous night. Why do they have to be your whole thing?
I said just the two of us. And you invite everyone!
You
I'm happy
fucking
for you!
Share some of your joy!
Congratulations, Eric! Thanks. Hey, I'm happy for you!
Fuck you!
Fuck you!
Fuck you!
Sing the fucking song. I'm not letting him ruin our night.
Darling, you
just do it.
Send me.
Thank you.
Honey, you send me. Darling, you send me. Honest, you do. Honest,
immature.
You do. Honest, you do.
You're a fucking immature.
Hey, yeah, you
thrill
me.
Darling, you ruin my whole fucking party, Rory. I want to punch your fucking dumb face.
Everyone's having fun. Thrill
me.
Look
at everybody. Honey, you.
Your wife's not having fun.
We're engaged.
Honest, you do.
Just everybody enjoy the song.
Honest, you do.
Just enjoy the song. Try to appreciate the night.
At first, I thought it was infatuation.
Unfucking believable.
But oh, it's.
Todd, Blake's here.
Blake's
hi,
here.
Hi, Chris. Good to see you.
Hi,
this is Adrenaline.
Okay, crank it up, Chris.
Sorry.
I want this to be fun when my friends come over.
We're in Jersey, Joe.
Can you crank it up? Tells you they can't see. Good. Go home. Go home. You can't see. I go home. Just play dumb. Go, yeah, you're going to have to go home. You can't see? Well, no, I can see. You're just, I can't see in your house because it's too dark in your house. Yeah, that's the way I keep it. Go home. Go home.
I get a zipper.
What?
I have buttons.
Yeah, the Angry Birds gets a zipper.
What does this have?
How do you know if this fits you?
Sometimes we forget that every person who lives in our neighborhood has worked their entire life not to live by 10 comedians in their 20s.